One of my favorite parts of video editing is creating speed ramps to really enhance the video footage. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to do this inside Premiere Pro. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
So to get started, I have a video clip in my timeline of a drone shot. And if we play this back, you can see what we have. It basically just pulls out and reveals more of a wider shot. So what a speed ramp is essentially is it basically remaps the time so it starts normal, it speeds up, and it slows down again. You can also use this for slow motion footage, but in this case, we're just working from normal footage. We want to speed it up so it goes faster, and then it speeds down to normal speed again. So to get started inside Premiere Pro, the first thing I recommend is expanding your track height. So I'm going to click and expand our track, and this will display our keyframe properties a little bit more better here, and you'll be able to make fine-tune adjustments easier. The larger that the track height is, the easier it is going to be to make adjustments to your speed ramp. Once you have it looking like this, the next part is to change our display from opacity to time remapping. So to do that, I'm going to right-click on our effects button and go to time remapping speed. You'll notice that this line appears and this displays the speed of the clip over time. So say if we click and drag this up, you can see that we are adjusting the speed. So if we click and release, you can see we remap the speed to 141%. If we play this back, it's going a lot faster. I'm gonna undo that for now by hitting Command Z, but the next part is to create keyframes at the different points that we want to adjust the speed. So what I recommend doing is adjusting your playhead at the point in time that you want to start speeding up your footage. Then you're gonna grab your pen tool by clicking P on your keyboard or selecting the pen tool. Then you can click once on this line to create a keyframe. Next, you can go out forward and find the point in time where you want to slow down again, maybe around here, and then click to make another keyframe. Next, I'm going to grab our selection tool, and now we can adjust the speed of the different areas. So this first section, we're going to leave at 100%. This middle section, we're going to speed up. So we're going to click and drag this up. As you can see, as we drag up, the other keyframe to the right is coming closer to the first keyframe, and we'll go up to maybe around 500 or so. And when we release, you'll notice that the clip gets shorter because there's less footage here. When we speed it up, we're going through the footage faster. Now this is speed ramping, and to create the ramp, what you can do is click and drag out from the edge of the keyframes to bring out a ramp. So you can see we just created ramps here. And if we click and play this back, this is what we have. So it speeds up and then it slows down there. We can fine tune this a little bit more. We can click and drag out these edges here of the keyframes or of the ramps to really fine tune it. Can even move the ramp around to depending which part of the footage that you want the ramp to occur during. So you can really fine tune this to your liking. I'm gonna zoom in here a little bit more, and you'll notice if we click in the middle here, this handlebar appears. This will apply some easing if you click and drag this handlebar down, so it's more of a curve as it speeds up or speeds down. So we can add some curves to our ramp, and now we have a nice steady speed ramp effect here. So if we click and play this back, we have a nice effect. And like I said, you can fine tune, adjust this to your liking. Sometimes you have to adjust the speed. Maybe if you want it to go faster, you can just click and drag the center up a little bit more so it happens a little bit quicker. All right, so now that we have our speed ramp, the next thing that you might want to do is add some motion blur. And to do this, we can easily add motion blur by using an adjustment layer. So what I'm going to do for this is I'm going to collapse our video track 1 so that we can see video track 2 above it here. Next, I'm going to create an adjustment layer by going to my new item button and going to adjustment layer. I'm going to click OK and then click and drag it out over our clips. Just make sure that it's over our entire clip here. All right, so next, navigate to the effects panel. So I'm going to go to my effects panel. If you don't see this, you can go up to Window Effects. And we're going to type in directional blur. I'm going to click and drag this to our adjustment layer here. And next, what we have to do is go out forward to where our speed ramp begins. So to do that, I'm going to click on our drone clip here and twirl down under speed. By using these left and right arrows, we can navigate to the beginning of our speed ramp. So I'm going to go to the first part of our speed ramp there, click back on our adjustment layer, and then add a keyframe by using the stopwatch tool next to blur length. Next, I'm going to click on my drone clip and go to the next keyframe by clicking the right arrow. This is the moment in time where it speeds up all the way. So next I'm going to go to my adjustment layer and adjust the blur length to maybe 30 pixels. And I'm also gonna adjust the direction. I'm just gonna change it to 90 degrees so it's going east and west or left and right. Then next, what I'm gonna do is go back to my drone clip and click on the right arrow. Then go back to the adjustment layer and create another keyframe by clicking this button here. And then lastly, I'm gonna go back to my drone clip and go to the last part of that time remapping, click on our adjustment layer and change the value to 0 to add a keyframe with the blur set to 0. And now when we play this back, you can see what we have. So you can see we added blur just during when it speeds up there. But you'll notice that it's over the entire footage. And for zoom out effects like this, when it comes to drone clips, what I like to do is add a vignette or essentially a mask where the blur only shows on the edge of the video clip. So to do that, what we can do is click on our directional blur here and add an ellipse mask. This will add a mask, and what we can do is just click and drag out these points to kind of place it around the edge of our frame here. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna click on this inverted button. So if you click on that, you'll notice that the blur only affects the outside of the mask. And now we can feather this up quite a bit, maybe to 400 pixels. We can even add more points here if we want and really get it looking nice around our edge of the frame here. That way it doesn't look completely like it's an ellipse mask. So feel free to adjust, add points as needed, and just get it looking pretty good. I'm gonna make some points around the top of the sky here. That way it kind of looks like the sky and the forest in the background is getting blurred as the drone moves out. And lastly, we can adjust our mask expansion if you want to bring out the effect a little bit more here. So now that we've done that, you can see what we have. I'm gonna go full screen here. We added blur just around the edge of the frame, and the middle here is still fine and completely in focus. So if we click and play this back, this is what we have. I'm gonna go full screen. And last thing here, you'll notice that there's a vignette occurring on the edge of the frame here. We can get rid of that by nesting our sequence. So if you'd like, we can select our clips here and right click on them and then go to nest. We can name this drone speed ramp and then click OK. And next, what we can do is click on this and just easily crop in by scaling in inside effects controls up to maybe 105. And now when we play this back, you can see what we have. So that's how you create speed ramps here inside Premiere Pro. If you want to learn more about Premiere Pro, there's several tutorials on my channel. I'll link one that you might like right up there. But that does it for this video. We'll see you guys in the next one. Take care.